Hi everyone, welcome to the Artem Chef channel. Well, except my channel, but I just like to say that because I'm cooking. Here's the dry yeast. I'm gonna add about 1 tablespoon of honey and 1/4 cup of 105 degrees water. We're gonna stir, we're gonna leave it for about 10 minutes. 1 tablespoon of olive oil. Into like a teaspoon of salt. I either just do it on my hands. After we add that, we're gonna add 3/4 cup, pretty much the same temperature water, which is 105 degrees, and we're gonna add 1 cup of all-purpose flour. So I'm gonna start stirring this until it gets a pretty good solid mixture. And 1 more cup of flour. And we're gonna mix it. As you can see, it's getting more and more like a dough. Now we're gonna add more flour. So this has been about 2 cups of flour so far. Now we're gonna add, I'll say 1/2 cup. Every time I do a pizza dough, it's kind of crazy, but it's never the same amount of flour. And I don't know if it's something to do with the temperature of water or with the flour consistency, but sometimes it takes more, sometimes it takes less. So I suggest you to add slowly. So what I'm gonna do now, actually, I'm gonna just put some flour on the table and I'm gonna start kneading that dough. So remember when I said it was about 2.5 cups? So this is where it's pretty much the third. What I'm looking to do is to combine it more together. And if it becomes sticky, just add more flour to the table, and that usually would do the trick. But don't overdo it either, because you don't want your dough to be too dry. How you usually do it, that's how my grandma used to do. So you like tuck it in, stretch, tuck it in, stretch. Looking kind of like this. So the next step in, you need to rest the dough. You need to put in a bowl. I use the glass bowl. I don't know, I like to use the glass bowl. You put olive oil inside. You take the dough, you put it inside. You kind of smidge it all over the place in olive oil. And then you cover it with the foil and leave it somewhere in a warm place for about, I don't know, until like 1.5 hours, almost 2 hours. This is what it looks like as a foil. Nice and sealed. You want to be sealed because you don't want the dough to get dry. Now we're gonna go to the actual pizza sauce that I make. The one thing that I like to buy is the whole peeled tomato versus actually already made the sauce itself. And I'm gonna add to it garlic. I'm not even gonna do much with it. Just peel it, garlic, easy peasy. I like garlic, so I usually make quite garlicky. And I feel like it adds some flavor.
That bun stands. See how perfect it is?
Mm-hmm.
Nothing.
Next, I take that sauce, I put it in a bowl, and I put it in the fridge. This is your sauce for pizza. All right, let's see how the dough is doing. This is the fireplace, and this is the dough. I just wrapped it in my hoodie. Remember what it looked like before, the dough? Now what it look like now. So it rises pretty good, it smells delicious, and actually give you like also a little thing that I do. I was out of actual regular olive oil, but what I actually use is black truffle flavored olive oil, this one. So I'm dividing them 4 and I'm gonna roll them in into a bowl. I'm gonna rest it for another, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes. The major thing is cover it, don't let your dough dry. Once it dries, it's just not gonna be the same. I'm just gonna use a bit of a flour on the table. So what I'm doing next is, I'm gonna cut it in 4. Take a dough, and what I'm doing is, I'm kinda like folding it in. I'm gonna do a little bit of oil as well on top of it, just to not make it too dry again. There we go. What I'm gonna do also, I'm gonna actually cover it with a towel as well. So that's what it looked like.
Four little pizzas.
Now it's time to make actual pizza. I heat up the oven 500 degrees. In the oven, it's probably take about 5 to 8 minutes. I'm gonna lay down, I'm gonna press in the center, and I'm gonna work my way out of the center. Once you get to the point where you kind of stretch out the dough with your fingers, there's multiple techniques that I've seen people do. It's like the stretching by knuckles, or just slowly stretching like that. And if you like it thin dough, you stretch it more. If you like it dough a bit thicker, you don't stretch it as much. You get like those occasional bubbles sometimes, which is great because it means that pizza is gonna rise. Another way of stretching pizza is by doing this. Okay, so it's pretty good size. Don't stretch it too much because sometimes what happens when you stretch it too much, it's hard to put it in the actual oven, because if it becomes too thin, it just kind of stops it. So what I also like to use breadcrumbs to put on top of it before I put a pizza on. So take a bit of a breadcrumbs. Now we're gonna drag that pizza. I'm gonna place it right on top of it. I'm gonna press a little bit harder over here to make that edge of the crust a little bit better, more rounded. There we go. Perfect. Now we're gonna put some sauce and all the cheeses, and I'm gonna throw it in the oven. So I sprinkle a little bit of olive oil, what we call it, to seal the sauce. Now you're gonna brush it. I'm gonna start with the Parmesan cheese first. So mozzarella, low moisture. What it means is that you're not gonna have a soggy pizza. I'm gonna top it off with the Parmesan more. There we go. Now you're gonna stick this in the oven for about 8 to 10 minutes. This is what pizza looks like out of the oven. And now I'm gonna cut it. There you go. And I guess you just say, bon appetit. Ah.